Hello students, we shall look at the numericals on module 1, that is temperature scales. We will see some 8 to 10 numericals, and before we start the numericals, we will see how to solve the numericals, because there will be a small derivation for the temperature relation, and then subsequently we will solve the numericals. Now you can see like temperature scales, consider a thermometric property X such that a temperature T is a linear function of the property. Now if you want me to show it, I'd like to show, suppose suppose I wish to show it on this is x axis, this is like temperature. Okay, now this becomes A, this becomes A, and this is slope. Okay, this is x. So you can see that x is a thermometric property and is a linear function and of this property, that is temperature. Okay, T is equal to A plus Bx, where A and B are constants which are obtained by measuring x at two known temperatures. So what are the known temperatures? As you all know, one is the ice point, that is 0 degree centigrade. Second is the steam point, that is 100 degree centigrade. So ice point we will represent as xi, and the steam point we will represent it as xs. Okay, now the equation is T, temperature is equal to A plus Bx. Fine. So that is equation 1. Now we found, we know that ice point xi is equal to 0 degree centigrade, steam point xs is equal to 100 degree centigrade. So substituting this value of xi and xs in the equation 1, okay, we get at steam point means T is 100 degree centigrade, is equal to A plus Bxs, because here it is steam point. That is equation 2 now. And ice point 0, that is ice point is 0 degree centigrade, is equal to A plus Bxi. Xi is ice point. So if you subtract this second equation from the first equation, 100 minus 0, you will get is 100. A gets cancelled because it is there in both the equation, and Bxs minus Bxi you will get. Again here B is common, so we will take out the B. The B, that is equation, is equal to B into in bracket Xs minus Xi. So this is the first part. So now you can see B is equal to 100 divided by Xs minus Xi. So now we have got the value of B. Let us consider it as equation 4. B is equal to 100 divided by Xs minus Xi. Now substituting this value of B in the equation,
we'll see A plus B xi is equal to 0. Now, if I take ice point equation relationship, at ice point 0 is equal to A plus B xi, okay. So, A is equal to minus B xi. I take the B xi on the right hand side, it becomes A is equal to minus B xi. So, that is equal to, now substituting the value of B here. B we know is 100 divided by xs minus xi. So, what we get? A is equal to minus 100 divided by xs minus xi. Entire thing into xi because it is minus b xi. So, considering all these equations 1, 4 and 5. Now, we got the value of 1 is t is equal to a plus bx. This is a linear relationship. Then equation 4 is the value of b, that is b is equal to 100 divided by xs minus xi, and 5 is value of a, that is minus 100 xi divided by xs minus xi. So, t is equal to a plus bx. Now, substituting value of a and b in this is equal to minus 100 xi divided by xs minus xi. Plus 100x divided by xs minus xi. So, you can see on the right hand side xs minus xi is common in both the denominator. So, we will take it common. Top 100 is common. Okay. And this minus 100 I will take it to the right side. So, I will rewrite it. Temperature in degree centigrade is equal to 100 x minus xi divided by xs minus xi. So, this relationship degree centigrade temperature is equal to 100 in bracket x minus xi, where x is the unknown temperature, xi is the ice point, xs is the steam point. We will use this we will use this relationship to find the unknown temperature.